Hi, my name is Ken and I'm a park naturalist here at Gulf Branch Nature Center, and this is another 5-minute find. Today I want to talk a little bit about metamorphosis. Insects go through metamorphosis, and most of us learn early on what complete metamorphosis is. It's a 4-stage process that starts with an egg, and from that you get a larva, and we're used to calling larvae different things like caterpillars or maggots are also larvae. And then you have a pupa. And then you have the adult, in this case, a painted lady. There's another form of metamorphosis called incomplete metamorphosis, in which you have the eggs, and the eggs hatch into nymphs, and these nymphs look like smaller versions of the adult, and they grow through a series of molts into an adult, in this case, a praying mantis. Insects like moths, butterflies, flies, beetles, all go through complete metamorphosis. But many insects also go through incomplete metamorphosis. This includes the bugs, the dragonflies and damselflies. This includes the praying mantis that we saw earlier. So what I thought I'd do is see if I can find some of these insects that go through incomplete metamorphosis and see what they're doing right now. Let's go see what we can find. Here's an example of an insect that goes through incomplete metamorphosis. This is an assassin bug, and this is its nymph. And this is a insect that will find and catch other insects and eat them. And it has a proboscis on its front, a piercing mouth part that it uses to pierce its prey and suck out the bodily fluids. Yum, yum, yum. This is a nymph of a green stink bug. You can see it's not very green right now. It's definitely advertising that it has a chemical defense that you don't want to mess with. Adults are a beautiful green that makes them very well camouflaged, but these nymphs do not have that green color just yet. You can also see it does not have its wings, so it's definitely not an adult yet. And it looks like it doesn't like the attention, and it might head under the leaf away from us there. This is a red-headed bush cricket, or a handsome trig, depending on which name you prefer. I think it's a pretty lucky insect to have two very wonderful common names. So the handsome trig is in the orthopteran family, which is crickets, grasshoppers, katydids. So they also go through incomplete metamorphosis, hatching from an egg, going through several instars as nymphs, where they look like miniature versions of the adults. Before a final molt where they get their wings. And then once they have their wings, they'll be able to call and mate. I'm about to show you the difference between a good site for molting and a not so good site for molting. When you emerge from an exoskeleton during a molt, your new exoskeleton is very soft because it's underneath the older one, which is smaller than your newer one. So you need to find a place to give your exoskeleton a chance to expand. And during this time, as an insect, you're vulnerable, or as any arthropod. This includes crabs, lobsters, spiders, centipedes, and millipedes. This hopper had a very good spot to molt, and its wings are nicely formed and in good shape. But if you look down here, this hopper did not have as good a spot to molt, and its wings look bent or even deformed. And this could have been a result of molting in a space where it did not have the area it needed in order to properly expand. And then when its exoskeleton hardened, it ends up with this deformity of the wings. And this can very seriously impact its ability to fly and obviously escape from predators. Dragonflies and damselflies, like this variable dancer, also undergo incomplete metamorphosis, but they do it with a little bit of a twist. Their eggs are laid underwater, and their nymphs develop underwater as predators, eating other small invertebrates, sometimes with the bigger dragonflies, even small vertebrates like tadpoles or fish. Eventually they grow big enough through a series of molts, where their final molt, they emerge from the water, exit their exoskeleton, and spread their wings, and they do this overnight in order to avoid being eaten by a predator. I always enjoy looking for insects. I hope you enjoyed your time with me today, and we'll see you again next week for another 5-Minute Find. Thanks and have a good day.